plant your tomatoes in a location where you haven't had tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, or potatoes for the past 3 to 4 years is going to be the best way to give your tomatoes a clean start. If this isn't possible, make sure you do a good job of cleaning out any residue at the end of the growing season so that as little of the fungal population or bacterial population can survive from one season to the next. Next, plant your crop and put a nice layer of mulch around the plant. This could be a plastic mulch, a landscape fabric, wood chips, or straw. And what this does is it creates a barrier in between the pathogen in the soil and the lower leaves of the plant. If you're watering your tomatoes, the best thing to do is to keep the water on the soil and not get the foliage wet. Our pathogens that infect the leaves need moisture on those leaves in order to spread and splash from one leaf to the next leaf. So get the water down low using either drip irrigation, a soaker hose, or just making sure that the garden hose is pointed at the base of the plant, not on the foliage. If you need to be out working in your garden and you've noticed that you have some leaf spots coming in on your tomato plants, wait until the foliage is dry before going and working in those plants. Our fungi and our bacteria reproduce and spread most easily when that moisture is on the leaves. So working in dry plants is a good way to reduce the amount of fungi and bacteria you're spreading on your hands and your tools as you're working in the garden. If you use a number of different cultural control practices like this, what you'll find is that you can reduce the pathogen, reduce the problems with the disease, even though you might not eliminate it altogether. But remember, we don't grow tomatoes to have beautiful green foliage. We grow tomatoes to have great, tasty tomatoes. In fact, a tomato can lose 50% of its leaves by August and still produce a great crop. So use some good cultural control practices to keep the disease in check so that we get the tomatoes we want by the end of the growing season.